Construction principles. So in software development life cycle, the process models you choose, the way you develop the software, it all starts with communication. You gather the requirement here. Then we do the planning, then the modeling or the design. And finally, you do the construction and then the delivery or the deployment. So this part, in this respect, what all principle as a software engineer, as a person working as a professional in software industry, when we are doing the coding or the testing, so the construction activity is all about, or it is having all the content of coding and testing. So coding can be done in various ways. Direct writing in code, that is the direct creation of programming language source code, for example, Java, C Sharp, etc. Then the automatic generation of source code, there will be intermediate design, and for example, the enterprise architect. So this is the second way. Then there is also a possibility of automatic generation of the executable code using the so-called fourth generation programming language. For example, Visual C, Hash, C, like this. Normally, we generally write the code by ourselves or use the pre-made code or the component which we already designed or written. So the initial testing at the component level is called unit testing. For example, you have written a function called add, simplest function. Now you have just defined certain variables, added and just printed or returned. So when we test this function or a group of functions that is called a module, that is called the unit testing, the basic level. Unit testing is the basic level testing, right? So this is the first part. This is the part where we need to test. Then comes the integration testing. The initial start with unit testing. Then we have the integration testing. That is, we have different parts. And these parts we are combining together. So when we are combining together, we need to do the integration testing. Now, user has given you some work, some requirement. These requirements have to be met as a complete system. So here we have to do the validation testing. Validation testing is done for the complete system or the software increment which has been delivered. So this is on the basis of the SRS or the, you know, requirement specification. Then finally, user has to accept. When the user is accepting, user is going to test it. It will be, the basic will be the requirement specification, but user has all its feature and function he wants. So the customer or the user will exercise all these required features and function and he will test for the acceptance. Preparation principles. Before you construct or go to the coding, there are certain fundamental principles which are equally applicable to coding as well as testing. That is, before you write a single line of code, you have to be very sure that you actually understand the problem. Normally, we just jump on coding, writing the code. But have we understood the problem? Are we aware of what problem need to be solved? What are the basic design principle and the concept? Because as a construction guy or a practitioner or a software programmer, you need to understand because the design, because the construction will be only done on the basis of the design. So you ought to know, you have to know the basic design principle. Then which programming language you have to use? For example, you may use a Visual Studio. You might use, say, NetBeans or Eclipse, any environment you can choose. But what environment or the programming language is best suited for the problem solution? You cannot take everyone. You just have to pick the best one. So you have to select the programming environment that will make your work easier. For example, you have debugger in it. You have some, you know, indentation, automatic static analysis can be done, or possibly the dynamic analysis can be done. So all these, before writing a code, you have to be very sure about all these aspects. And you have to do the unit test. Once you write a function, once you make a code, once you make a module or a component, you have to do the unit test, because the unit test is the responsibility of the practitioner. Coding principles. a practitioner or a coder or the programmer, what are the principles he has to follow? So as we begin writing actual code, we have to follow certain practice, like the structured programming practice. We were using the functional, object-oriented. There are so many type of programming paradigm or practice. But constrain your algorithm, because before coding you have to write the algorithm, or you have to follow certain algorithm. So make modularization, make functions, and those they should have the loose coupling. The function should have cohesion, and all the programming constructs you are going to use, that is already given in the structured programming. It's again a different concept. The structured programming has given what all you have to use. As the agile is suggesting, especially the extreme programming, pair programming, that is one person is coding, the other person is at the same time simultaneously, he is looking for the quality assurance issues, for the errors, for the bugs. If one person is coding, the other person may look for the standards to be followed. So 1 and 1 becomes 11, not 2. Select the data structure that meets the design. Coding is all on the basis of the models or the design model or the design. So what data structure is actually conforming to the design? For example, tech stack you have to use, linked list you have to use, some array list you have to use. This should meet the design which was earlier made. Now understand the software architecture and create. As I said, the design comes out of architecture. So architecture is all about where you are going to fit. Architecture is the skeleton of the software. So where you have to fit your component, you need to know. And the conditional logic, that is if else, the loops, the logical, the component, the logical construct you are using. So you are using a lot of ands, sort of ors, and these are so many nesting going on. So logic is where you are actually putting all the effort. And the problems also come there. So if you create multiple nested loops, for example, if else inside if else inside if else, and this goes on and on and on, it will be very difficult to test them wherever the problem is. Then you have to choose the meaningful variable names. For example, you are making a function called add and you are returning some value. So you are naming it, say, my fine day, one fine day, my name. These are not logical. The variable name should be something like add result or result of addition. These are the meaningful names. There are so many coding standards in industry being followed, like MISRA, etc. But the coding standard, if the company has decided, you must use the local coding standards. Write code that is self-documenting. Most of the time when we write some function, most of the good programmer, they write comment. Or they make some pictures, that is to prove and to ensure that the other person may know, and if he or she visits again, he must understand what he has done. That is, they are creating a visual layout, indentation, blank lines. This aids, this helps in understanding. For example, if else is there, if you want to write one more if else inside it, you will not write on one line. Or this vertically, they will not be in one line. There will be some indented, some a tab, a four characters ahead. This will be a visual aid or help to the other people who are going to say a technical review or code walkthrough. Validation principle. So what you have done is good or bad. After completing your first code, you see here we have a wash basin. The water is coming out when you put your hand in front of the sensor, but the water is flowing out of the wash basin. So here is a problem. Everything is working fine. But the actual problem is what was not defined or designed earlier. So you have to conduct a code walkthrough. Just go through the code. And as I said, you have to perform unit test and you need to correct the errors then and there. And then you can do the refactoring of the code. If some code is there, you have written four lines for certain thing. If it can be done in one line, then the basic is good. Refactor it.